Hello and welcome back to my channel. We are at the airport. We are going to go to our gate and then we are going to Disneyland.
All right, let's get some plane snacks. But the room wasn't ready, so we got ready in the bathroom. But we are now currently heading to Disneyland for Shelby's first time. Yay! We made it in! Almost. We're gonna go that way to Disneyland. But it's so cute. I love all the Pixar Fest stuff. Are you excited?
Very excited.
We have to get her some fucking coffee because she's about to go to night-night. We're in! We're gonna go get a locker, put our stuff down, and then I need a new tote bag because the one I brought is not comfortable at all. Lots of characters out. Look, there's Mickey way back there. All right, it's gonna be Shelby's first time seeing the castle. A Disney Worlder seeing the Disneyland castle for the first time.
Horse.
About to get run over by the horse. See it?
It's so little.
It is very little. They have a whole bunch of Pixar Fest merchandise, and then here's the new Inside Out plushies. They're so cute. They also have little munchlings, a little Pixar Fest hat, some kids' clothes, and then they also have this adorable mug. I'll be taking that home. And they have this tote bag, which I think is really cute. So cute. I'm obsessed. All right, I checked the Emporium and they didn't have the tote bag, so I'm hoping they have it in here. It would be over here though. Oh yeah, that's adorable. Little Winnie the Pooh shirt. Oh my God, they have slippers. We didn't get those at Disney World. Oh, and it looks like they've got the sweatshirts that are very popular. Okay, I found my tote bag. They didn't have the one I wanted, but now we are at Starbucks. We're gonna get some coffee, and then I need to add Shelby to my account, and then we're gonna book a ride, maybe try a snack, go see the castle. Okay, I got my coffee, a decaf white chocolate mocha latte, and of course I had to bring Remy for Pixar Fest.
Yum.
Okay, we are in line for our first snack of the trip. I told Shelby she has to try. She's not paying attention. She has to try a churro for her first snack. Look how cute this little Edna Mode bottle topper is for Pixar Fest. I am so obsessed. She's so cute. Hi, we're gonna do one churro and one pineapple churro.
One regular churro and one pineapple churro.
Okay, we got our churros. We got regular and pineapple, and then it came with a pineapple dipping sauce. That looks good. It says it said pineapple cookie dipping sauce. Better than Disney World?
I've never had one.
Oh, well then you can't compare, but yes, they are better. Okay, I want to try the pineapple one. Okay, we're gonna take Shelby in the castle. So it like tells the story.
Oh.
the fairies will sprinkle dust. All right, let's check out the Pixar, I think it's called Pixar Pal Around. Look how cute that sign is. They also have food and drinks over here as well. I wanna check it out. I saw someone with a baked potato. It looks really good. Right now they're doing a dance party. It looks so cool in here. We're in line to meet Barley. He's the only character out right now for meet and greets. I don't know if Ember and Wade are up there though. Luca and Alberto just got here. They have Radiator Springs with the Piston Cup. I'm trying to get a video of Barley really quick because we just met him. So I'll insert a picture like right over here. He looks so cool. All right, we're heading into Mickey's Toontown. We found a little butterfly just chilling out on this barrel. He's so cute. They have new sippers. They've got Mickey and Minnie and they have Donald. I'm gonna have to get those. All right, let's go into Mickey's house. Anything with Walt. What is that? A globe. Oh, look at Pluto's bed. We found some Disneyland magic. Shelby got that one. They're the same, obviously, but she found them over there just like randomly on the trash can. They're so cute. I love this.
Okay, we just did Mickey and Minnie's Runaway Railway. We tried to do the Roger Rabbit ride, but as we were in line, they bumped the wait to an hour, and I was not going to do that. And then we met Pete. I'm going to insert a photo, like, in here somewhere. Now we are heading to It's a Small World.
Please remain seated throughout your voyage, keeping your hands,
please remain
arms,
seated,
and legs inside the boat.
All right, we stopped for a little snack. We got the cheesy garlic bread and then we got bratwurst. So yummy.
Okay, so we got our snacks from the stand across from the Matterhorn. They have turkey legs, the cheesy garlic bread, which I didn't know they had that there, and then the bratwurst. I haven't had the bratwurst before. It is delicious. 10 out of 10 for that. And of course the cheesy bread, as you guys know, is always so good. But I can't wait for Tony and I to come back because he's really gonna love this.
There's Ariel. Just looking out at the water. That's so cool.
Okay, so we just got done our snacks. Shelby's sitting down, but I've got our spot secured for Magic Happens. It's gonna be her first time seeing it. I'm so excited because it is literally the best parade.
They're playing Beauty and the Beast. smells like apples. I got some cast member magic. He liked my wish tattoo. It's star on my arm. So he gave me an honorary citizen of Disneyland. I guess the other ones we found were probably just given to people and they just discarded them on top of the trash can, but I'm keeping this forever. They have Fantasmic popcorn and the packaging is so cute. Of course we have to do Alice in Wonderland, one of my favorites.
Look at little live rabbit. Have a look around. Oh, Mr.
Rabbit, wait, please. It went this way.
I am lucky too.
I got a Monsters, Inc. Pandora charm. I'll have to open it and show it to you guys later. But when you open the door, Boo is inside. It's so cute. But they didn't have any Pixar Fest ones, which I was surprised that they didn't come out with one. So I got this to commemorate the Pixar Fest at Disneyland. All right, we're doing some shopping right now, and then we're actually gonna head back to the hotel. I'm gonna do a little room tour to show you guys. We are staying at the Grand Legacy. They were so kind to host us for this trip. So we're gonna head back over there, and then we'll come back to the parks later. But let's do some shopping. All right, I came back for the Pixar stuff. I am gonna grab one of these mugs to take home because it's so cute, and it's for Pixar Fest, so I'm gonna grab that. Of course, I had to grab the Pixar Fest pins. This one is for the Magic Key, and then this is just one that they have. It is so stinking cute. Okay, we're leaving Disneyland. We are going to head back to the hotel, check in. I'm gonna do a little room tour for you guys and show you our room. And then we're gonna rest a little bit, change, and come back to Disneyland for all of the nighttime festivities. I think we're gonna do the fireworks show tonight. And then obviously do some rides that we didn't do today, eat some more food. But yeah, let's go back to the hotel. All right, here's where we're staying. We're gonna go inside and check in. There's Shelby. Look how cool this mural is. I'm obsessed. The lobby is so pretty. It also smells really good in here. They even have a little water bar with some popcorn. This morning they had free coffee and flavored creamer, which is my favorite. So I'm really excited about that. I'm definitely gonna be grabbing a cup for tomorrow. They even have some pin trading boards, which is really cool. The other board has some good ones. I'm gonna show you that right now. So they have this board. If I had my pins with me and not my suitcase, I would definitely grab Elliot and that one. Okay, we just got to the room. First off, hello. Let me say, it is so clean and it smells so good in here, but look what they left us, a little goodie basket. There's some smart water in there, some candy, and then I even saw there's like a little keychain, and they have like little Mickey balloons. It's so cute, but it is so nice in here. First off, I love the artwork. They have this one, and then they also have this one here. I really like this one. And then this is the bathroom area. Super clean. We've got some products here. So nice. And then this is like the shower toilet area. Again, so freaking clean. Also, I love this tile. It's so pretty. But this is where we're gonna be for the next 3 nights. I'm so excited. Shelby's out there waiting for me. I was like, hang on, I have to film first. But we are going to put our stuff down, come in, relax a little, get situated. And then, like I said, we'll be heading to the parks later on tonight. We're heading back to Disneyland. We're going on Pirates.
Oh, one. Can't you reach any further, you stuck wind? Bill's right.
I just did it for a quick.
Take this poultry sum to start them to cover my expenses. And a chest of jewels. Drink up, be hearty, show out.
Well, Disney World Pirates or Disneyland Pirates?
Disneyland,
by far. For sure, 100%. We got a spot for the fireworks show.
Thank you.
right, we just got out of the fireworks show, and then we came to get some dinner. I just got a burger, plain, and then ketchup and fries. I accidentally grabbed way too much ketchup, and then Shelby's getting her order. She got fish and chips and the popcorn bucket for her husband. But this actually looks really good. I usually don't get a burger, but I don't know. It looks pretty yummy. I actually wish they had pickles. Okay, there's Shelby's fish and chips, and she got fries because she got the popcorn bucket, but that actually looks so good.
Okay, we just got done a very late dinner. We are actually going to head back to the room, get some rest because it has been a long travel day, travel morning. We had to wake up at like 3:30 a.m. So we're going to go back to the room, hang out, sleep, and then we have a DCA all day tomorrow. I'm so excited because they have the Pixar parade. They've got like food booths. I can't wait to try like all of the food. And then I think we can meet some of the characters, but that's the plan for tomorrow. So until tomorrow, bye. Good morning. We are on our way to DCA. We're going to be doing all of the DCA stuff because Shelby's obviously never seen it. And then we're going to be doing all the Pixar stuff, which, like I said yesterday, they have a meet and greet with May and her mom. They have food booths. They have like Club Pixar. So many things. So come with us on our DCA day.
All right, we made it. We're going to go scan in. And I really want to go check Bing Bong to see if they have the new DIY ears, because apparently they're supposed to drop in June. It's June 1st, but you know, a girl can hope. First up on the menu, get some Starbucks.
All right, we're walking into DCA and heading to Pixar Pier, but here's some of the food booths. We've got Gusto's to go.
We're definitely going to be trying some of these for sure. There's Elemental Table. And then I know they've got a Turning Red booth. I'm so excited. We've got Four Town Favorites. Favorites. That's so cute. The food looks delicious. Also, that drink. Definitely going to be stopping here. They also have a little Pixar Fest maps. Yes. No, it was someone else. I think it was this thing. But they've got the Pixar map. So it shows you like where the food is. What's the back say? Four Town Favorites, the Spark. Ooh, Porto Rosso pasta. Oh my gosh, I'm so excited. Okay, you guys, look what I just found. I am freaking obsessed, but wait a minute. Let me show you the back. You guys, I'm getting it. I don't want it to sell out. They also have this one, which is so cute. Look, you guys, they even have Pixar Fest cotton candy. That is so cute. There's the Porto Rosso pasta booth that we'll definitely be checking out later. Right now I'm on a mission. I don't know if I already said it, but I'm on a mission. We're gonna go to Bing Bong's and see if by any chance they dropped the like ears that you can make with all the different characters. So that's where we're heading right now. All right, you guys, we're at Bing Bong's and they do not have the ears. I'm super sad. I'm praying that before I leave on the 3rd that they drop again.
Now hands in the air. 2, 3, 4. Go green. No, no, Zerg's trying to stop our fun. We gotta dodge his ping pong balls. Whoa. Whoa. Oh no, he's not done with us yet. Whoa, that was a close one. Whoa, another one. All right, he's out of batteries. Back to the fun. Hands in the air.
Look how cute these signs are in Cars Land for Pixar Fest. They're always so clever.
Okay, we're getting ready to get on the Radiator Springs Racers.
I forgot what it was called for a second and had to look at the sign.
new race car.
Yay.
To the starting line.
Time for Mater's Junkyard Jamboree. Look at the babies. There's the mama and all her babies. So cute. I want to pet them. We're finally getting some food. We're at the Turning Red booth. We're gonna get the Red Panda Bao to share, and then we're also gonna get the Nobody Like You cooler. We're gonna come in here to eat. I love that they have like separate places to eat for Magic Key holders. I think that's just such a nice touch. Also, look at that cute photo op. Okay, we got the Nobody Like You cooler. It's a non-alcoholic. I think it's got like rose tea and some like fruit mix in there. And then a bao bun, which was a pork.
I think so.
A pork bao bun, and then it comes with like a chili garlic sauce. It looks so good. Okay, this is delicious. I'm giving this a 9 out of 10. It is so good. That's a little like orange gummy. So good. And then the bao bun, I also tried. I'm gonna give this a 10 out of 10, it's good. I did try it without the sauce though, so I'm gonna do that now. What do you think? This is spicy? Oh, the chili garlic. Do you like the drink?
I do.
What do you give it?
9 out of 10.
What do you give the bun?
9 out of 10, but also I feel like the spice ruined it for me.
So try it without the sauce. I just tried a piece of the gummy. It's good. It's just an orange gummy, but it's really actually refreshing. Okay, I just tried it with the garlic chili sauce. I'm changing this to a 10 out of 10. It's so good. I definitely recommend the bao bun from the Fort Chan booth. All right, next up, elemental table. All right, here's the menu. It all looks really good. It's actually impossible chicken too. But the cold nut whoopie pie cookie, that looks delicious. All right, so that's the H2 Rita from the elemental table. I tried it. I don't like it. Shelby likes it though. And then this is like the impossible chicken they have. They don't have forks, but I think they're like chicken fingers anyway. I don't really know what this is, but you know, I'm gonna try it. This actually looks and smells really good though. Okay, I've already tried this. It is delicious. I'm gonna give this an 8 out of 10 just because I really like some bao bun. But it tastes like chicken. It's impossible chicken. It's got a barbecue sauce on it that has a little spice. And these are little pickles that were on the plate, so I added them on top. I'm gonna try it with the pickles. Okay. 10/10 with the pickles. So freaking good. All right, we're gonna check out Gusto's to go. I have a feeling, yep, ratatouille. Or how do you say it? Ratatouille. Ratatouille. Oh, they also have a little Gusto macaroon.
Babysitting.
Who am I babysitting?
Oh, I just realized it's a ratatouille pizza. So it's topped with mozzarella, eggplant, squash, zucchini, a drizzle of tomato sauce, and a wedge of French something. Oh, it looks like brie cheese. Oh, you know what? I think I'm actually going to skip this booth, but I might get that later. We're just not feeling very sweet right now. Okay, we're going to check out Club Pixar after we do the Monsters, Inc. ride because it's so cute. So, of course, we have to do that. And then we're going to see what they have around here. I think I saw they have, like, some free games somewhere. I know they have some photo ops, so we're definitely going to check it out.
Okay, well, Monsters, Inc. is down right now, so we're going to have to do that later. So, let's go check out Club Pixar.
All right, so some of the games are over here. They've got a little short stop drive-in theater with some cars that you can sit in and watch some different shorts. But they've got this free game back there, a couple of them. And then they have some over there as well. But they're from 4:30 to 8:30 p.m. So if you're coming to Pixar Fest, keep that in mind. They've got this little Buzz Lightyear photo op. So cute. They have a Mr. Incredible meet and greet over here. So cool. The line actually isn't too bad. And he's in his blue suit. They also have this Wally photo op. That's so cute. They also do have a food booth back here for Pixar Fest. It's Hangar Management. So it's Anger from Inside Out. I'm gonna see what they have. It looks like they've got, ooh, they've got some good stuff, it looks like. So it says choose your emotional mac and cheese. They have joyful yellow comforting mac and cheese with cheese puffs. Angry red hot mac and cheese with spicy cheese crunch, and they also have the mood swing, which is like both of them, and they do have a mood stabilizer mule here as well. The joyful yellow comforting mac and cheese sounds really good.
So if I'm not mistaken, I want to say that at night this turns into Club Pixar, so I think they have like music and probably dancing. The games are obviously open for you to use, so when we after we take our break and like go back to the hotel, we'll come back and we'll check it out later on tonight and see what's going on.
We are doing the Animation Academy. We're gonna be drawing Wade. This is my first time doing it, so I'm so excited.
And we'll help you with whatever it is you need. If you need to leave at any time, do not go out that door, or any of these doors. Go out that door right there that Sam is now pushing open with all her might, that rather heavy third door. But on the other side of that heavy door, restrooms and churros, so it's worth the effort. Okay? I know. Strawberry very lightly. At first, don't make heavy dark lines right away that you can't erase, okay? Draw really, really lightly. You can put down several lines, and by the end of it, you can darken in the good lines, and you'll have a wonderful drawing of Wade from Elemental. By the way, he's right there under the screen next to Emperor. Can you see him?
Ooh.
All right, let's get down to it. Eagle, just ever so slightly. So this side of his face, we're gonna see his cheek coming out. So right here where this crossing guideline starts, I'm just gonna bring that cheek out a little bit. I'm gonna build it up just like this. It's gonna flow right into the top and the bottom of our original oval, just like that. That's gonna give him a very lovable look. Next up, we're going to draw in his neck and shoulders by going down here. Now, he's a pretty big guy, you know. He's big, but he's lovable. And he's made of water. If you haven't seen Elemental, it's a wonderful film. Here comes the shameless plug. It's on Disney Plus. You can see it there. And I highly recommend that you do. It's a really delightful film. And it came out last year. It looked like everybody was saying, oh, well, it's not going to be another. It's another non-hit for Pixar and Disney. But then this movie was so wonderful. Spit it out, Thomas. That eventually it caught on and people started going to see it. The word of mouth really grew on Elemental, and it did get nominated for an Oscar last year for Best Animated Feature too. So that's a testament to its director, Pete Sohn. I'll tell you a little bit about Pete in just a minute or two. But I'm going to draw in the neckline of Wade's jersey because he's a sports fan. In the elemental world, he is a fan of a team called the Windbreakers. Yeah, the Windbreakers. They play a game called Airball in that place. And that's his favorite team. So he wears this jersey to represent the team. There's the neckline of it, just two curves coming down. And you can see that I felt pretty good. I've already committed to those. I gotta bring those shoulders down a little bit so I can bring down some colored sleeves like this, just from that neckline. And when you shade this in, you know, it's gonna look just like a sports jersey should.
Thank you, Thomas. All right, everyone, thanks so much for joining us.
Okay, we came back after doing our little animation academy. Now we are heading on to Monsters.
I'm not sure if it's a demon. Vincey, there has never been a child security breach in Monstropolis. Can you imagine what would happen if a human child ever did enter our city? So let's give a big yay for the CDA. They keep Monstropolis human toxin free. The gray, the yellow, the CDA.
Security breach for the first time in monster history.
We can neither confirm nor deny.
The doll. It's true. I saw the whole thing.
Happy birthday, Schmoozy Poo.
Oh, googly dog.
Hey, Tony's grocery.
It made me dance like a chicken. My thoughts were not my own. And it grabbed me.
Oh, Boo, we gotta get you home.
There's a kid here! A human kid!
Come on, this way!
Situation is 9 0. Security area.
Spread out and lock it down.
Mrs. Incredible is out meeting now, and she's so cute. So cool. We got a spot for the Pixar parade. I'm so excited.
Can you look?
Can you look?
Can you look?
We're gonna go back to the room. We're gonna change because the temperature should start dropping soon. And then we're actually gonna come back to DCA, do Avengers Campus. There's still some food booths that we haven't tried. I don't know how much vlogging I'm gonna do once we get back or like after it gets dark, just because I have to use like my flashlight for you guys to see me or find like good lighting. And the flashlight blinds me. But anyway, we're going back to the hotel, gonna change, and then we'll be back. Okay, so we're walking back to Disneyland. We did stop at this, what's called, Mochi Donut Cafe, and they have Korean corn dogs and mochi donuts. I had the plain mochi donut, and it was delicious. I'm gonna give it like 9 out of 10, but then we also got a crispy ramen half cheese, half like hot dog, and that was delicious. Also, I should mention that they are literally connected to the Grand Legacy Hotel. So right as you walk out of the Grand Legacy and you're heading to Disneyland, which is literally a 2-minute walk, They're like located right there, which is really cool. They also have like a pizza and boba place that I want to try. So I'm gonna hopefully try that tomorrow, or maybe if they're open later than 11 and we're not back yet, we'll try that tonight.
We had to come back and get another bao bun. It's so good.
This is awesome. Buddy, you could stop doing that now. But anyway, you guys are here today to help assess the web slinger vehicle. Using onboard tech, you will be able to sling web just like my buddy Spider-Man.
Peter, your presentation is getting away from you.
Yeah, I'm aware of that, Sharon. If you could just initiate the safety protocols, it'd be greatly appreciated.
Problem with that,
so
Peter.
Anyway, if you want to sling a web, all you gotta do is sling your arm in the direction you want to shoot the web, and that's it. It's awesome.
Peter, your spider webs are continuing to replicate and are consuming everything in their path.
They seem to be stuck in self-replication mode. If you could just handle that for me, please.
On it. Contacting Mr. Stark.
Don't call Mr. Stark! Don't call Mr. Stark. Sorry, Shadow. Could you just call someone else and ask them to do it?
Okay. Contacting Spider-Man.
I'm gonna go find Spider-Man for us all, because he's around here somewhere. Okay, goodbye.
Spider-Man!
As you may have noticed, the spider bots are locked in that awesome self-replication mode.
There's Loki just hanging out, doing a little meet and greet. We just got off Web Slinger, so now we're just walking around Avengers Campus. We're gonna go check out Avengers Vault. See what kind of merch they've got. Iron Man suit. See if I can find anything for Tony. Captain America. That's his favorite. That's kind of a cool shirt. All right, we're gonna try the Porto Rosso pasta. There's the menu there. It's a pesto pasta. It looks really good. All right, we got our food. That is the Porto Rosso pesto pasta, I think I said. And then that is the Silencio like alcoholic drink. That's for Shelby. This actually looks really good. I thought the green beans were still frozen, but honestly, I think that they're just freeze-dried. And it's a pesto pasta with green beans, and it has potatoes on it, oddly enough. But we're gonna go ahead and try it. All right, so we tried it. At first, I wasn't really a fan because it tasted too plain, but once you've really mixed it up, it tastes a lot better. But it has like the potatoes, the green beans. The pesto sauce is really good. It's actually like a little like garlicky, but as you can see, like all the pesto is like there at the bottom. I would probably rate this a 7 out of 10. I don't know if I would get it again.
Okay, we are leaving DCA. We went back. We honestly didn't do too much. We're kind of tired. We have reservations at Plaza Inn tomorrow at 9:30, I think. So we're gonna go back to the hotel. We're gonna relax a little bit, change into our PJs, watch some TV. I'll probably do some editing and like content stuff. And then we'll wake up tomorrow, head to Disneyland, do the Plaza Inn, and just some other things. I definitely want to meet Wade and Ember tomorrow. So yeah, until tomorrow, bye. Good morning. We are on our way to Disneyland. We are going to the Plaza Inn for breakfast. So I'm just up as Minnie. I'm pretty sure they had Daisy there, but anyway, Shelby's dressed up as Daisy. So it's Minnie and Daisy taking on Disneyland today. We're definitely gonna get some pictures. I grabbed some coffee at the Grand Legacy Hotel. They have free coffee in the lobby. And it's really good. They have flavored creamer, decaf coffee, which that's what I drink. And they also obviously have regular coffee as well. But we are about to be walking into Disneyland, and I will bring you guys along for our day. It is our last full day in the parks, and I don't know. It just went by so quick. I almost wish that we were staying a little bit longer, but that's okay. Let's go to Disneyland.
We're back in Disneyland. Let's go get some breakfast.
Is she out?
Yeah.
Okay, we're about to get to the Plaza Inn. We're gonna check in for our reservation. I'm so excited.
Our tables, they come say hi and everything.
Okay.
Like you have to go and like find them, or you know, they'll come to you or you say hi.
This is hilarious.
I was so excited.
Eeyore! All of the characters are walking around. There's so many. There we go. It's a giant cup.
Oh, I should have got a giant cup.
You want a giant one?
Yeah.
All right, what do I want? I want orange juice. They have orange juice.
There was a dispenser right there. That's not an order.
Got our breakfast. We've got mini waffles instead of Mickey waffles. This is like a country scramble chicken and a biscuit with gravy and then potatoes. It looks so good. We've also got some characters coming around. We've got Perla, Daisy, and then I think it's, yep, it's Chip down there. Ew. Have a good day. Okay, we just got done breakfast at the Plaza Inn. We met so many characters. I'm gonna insert a bunch of pictures probably, I don't know, somewhere around here. But we are gonna go do some rides and then I think go to like the Pixar Pal around and see if we can meet Ember and Wade because I really wanna meet them. But today's just gonna be a chill day. We're gonna do Disneyland and then I think we're gonna pop over to DCA later in the afternoon. Hi, Gaston. Okay, I was gonna say, I mean, there's no mirrors over here.
I know, that's the problem, right? That
yeah.
was the real one, but I just get lost in my eyes so much.
Right, just stand yeah. there for hours staring at yourself.
I don't have my face on any of the stuff in here. It's kind of weird.
No, yeah.
So sold out.
They should have a whole entire, like, tavern or something.
I keep telling them that. Yeah.
Yes, yeah.
I
They're
said,
slacking.
I do have one at Disney World. I said, that doesn't
You
help.
Do,
doesn't
and help. You have really great Cinnabons there.
You do have really yeah. Cinnabons
yeah.
there.
Yeah.
Yep.
yeah.
You know, Maurice, he makes a good churro of gear here.
Okay.
Don't tell him I said that.
Yeah, we won't. We won't.
All right, I'll be back.
Awesome. Okay, have fun.
Back to the kingdom. We're going to go into the side of the royal
hall. Just take your exodus and we'll be on your way.
Nana. Goodbye.
Toad Hall. To ensure a safe and glorious drive in your motor car, remain firmly seated, hands, arms, feet, and legs inside. Watch your children, and don't try to drive more carefully than Toad.
Ah!
No, now let's stop.
You take it. That is all.
They really said, damn you to hell. I love this billboard so much. Definitely one of my favorites in the park.
Now if you come, you can safeguard your miraculous journey. Here in your transportation devices are ingenious pouches for safekeeping all earthly treasures when the journey becomes bumpy. And to keep you safe and sound, here are special belts attached into the seats. Simply pull it from the right, inserting it into the left, like so. You see the excellence of this invention? Your off-road journey is high-speed and turbulent.
Look into my eyes. Your path now leads to the gates of doom.
See the look on Captain Jack Sparrow's face when he hears tell it is only me what's got the lunch.
Look what I just spotted outside of the Pirates ride. It's a Fantasmic crew neck. And I love that it doesn't say Disneyland, so I can wear it to Disney World too. It's so cute. Okay, we just got off Pirates. I grabbed that Fantasmic crew neck. Now we're heading over to Harbor Galley. We're going to get the cookies. It'll obviously be Shelby's first time trying them, but they're so good. I ended up getting a 13 pack so we can save some for later in the hotel room. They look so good. Okay. Go ahead and grab one. Cheers. Boop. What do you think?
So good.
Right? They're so yummy. All right, Shelby got popcorn and I did not realize that it is like a Pixar Fest bucket. She also got waters. Thank you so much. So I'm going to grab one They also have this magic key Doug bucket, and I don't know if I should get it. He is cute, but I don't know. I don't even know if I'm gonna be able to fit him in my luggage. All right, you guys, I got him, and I didn't think he made noise, but he does, and I was like literally started tearing up. But let's see if you guys can hear him. Squirrel. He just said squirrel.
Hi there, my name is Doug.
Hi there, my name is Doug.
I have just met you and I love you.
I have just met you and I love you. Oh my god, he's so cute. And then here's the Pixar Fest, just like the normal bucket, turning red. I mean, that alone was like the seller for me. I freaking love them. All right, did a quick outfit change. We're heading to the Pixar Pal like area, obviously hoping to meet Ember and Way from Elemental. So we're gonna go do that, see what characters are out. We did grab a lightning lane for Jungle Cruise, so I think we're gonna do that as well, but we'll see.
We might give you the vlog.
We might change it, but right now let's head over to Pixar Pal Around and see who's out. There's Pinocchio and Geppetto. So cute. We also got the band here. I just truly love that about Disneyland. So many characters just out and about enjoying the day. Okay, so they are out meeting right now, but they closed the line. So we're just gonna have to come back and see if we can meet them, I guess, later. So we're gonna hang around this area, maybe try some of the food, drinks, and see what other characters are out and about. Okay, look what I just found. Panda Mae straw clip. I'm definitely getting that. And then they have this really cool coffee. Kind of looks good. And then I'm gonna check out the menu once we get up, like our turn in line. I think if I mix it up, it'll actually taste like strawberry and cream. There's also like a little popsicle in there. This is the Roundup Rodeo barbecue and jacket potato. This is also really good. There's Ian from Onward and Barley. I met Barley the other day, but I wasn't able to meet Ian.
Feeling into our feet. All right, and I just really enjoy. First, we walk the park like this, and now jump for joy.
Jungle Cruise. We're gonna stop and get a spicy pickle, but we were at the Pixar area for quite a while because I wanted to meet Alberto and Luco, which I did, and then I waited for Ember and Wade. They were so sweet. I'm gonna put the photos in here somewhere so you guys can see. I did get a little bit of YouTube video of them as well, so I'm gonna put that in the next few clips, but let's go to Jungle Cruise and get a spicy pickle. It'll obviously be Shelby's first time trying them. Disney World has pickles, but we don't have the spicy ones, so let's go try one.
All right, spicy pickles. It's not too spicy. It's not as spicy. Do you want to share one or you want your own?
What do you want to do?
I was going to share.
Okay.
Okay. Because I'll probably have like two bites. All right. First spicy pickle. Is it too spicy?
Spicy. I've been doing it.
But do you like it?
Yes.
Okay, it's not too spicy?
Would I get another spicy one in the future?
Probably not. Oh, okay, so too spicy? All right, well, I'll try it.
My lugger.
I just had a couple bites. Sorry, my lens is reading. The spicy pickles are so good. I wish Disney World would bring them. I don't really understand why they don't have them and they just do the regular pickles. Like, I feel like it's not gonna take, it wouldn't take that much effort to get them, but I don't know. 10 out of 10, it is so good. Shelby did say she wouldn't get it again though, so. But she's eating it, so I guess that's a good sign.
Supervise those children because they don't pay me enough to do it for you. All right, welcome to the tropical rainforest where it rains 365 days a year. Some people think that's almost every day. And here we are at the Temple of Forbidden Eye, and we've got our first sight of land mammals. You know, the young ones can latch on for 18 to 40 years and they'll really eat you dry. They're mostly only vulnerable to their number one predator, inflation. And that snake statue means only one thing. We're in the Cambodian shrine. You know, that snake statue is made out of brass. Oh, wow. Okay, we got a Bengal tiger over here on the right. And some people told me those are gators around there, but it's just a croc. That down there, speaking of crocs, that's Ginger. Watch out, Ginger snaps. And yeah, she's one tough cookie. And can anybody tell me what this is right here? Did I hear elephant? If so, you are correct. That's concrete evidence. We're about to see some elephants. Yep. Buckle up, folks. We're just getting started. And here we are in the Indian elephant bathing pool. Feel free to take pictures because they've all got their trunks on. Wow. Looks like the whole... And that brings us to the African elephant.
Back to the hotel for a little bit to just kind of relax. We're gonna change and then head back to Disneyland, but I wanted to show you guys the pool area here at the Grand Legacy. There is a few people in here, so I'm gonna have to like be really careful with filming, but I just wanted to show you guys so you can see like the pool area. It looks like there might be like a little splash area too, so let's check it out.
All right, so here's the splash pad area. Super cute. And then I'm gonna show you guys the pool. There is also a hot tub as well. But the splash pad area is really cute. It looks like you might be able to like move this one. Let's see. Oh yeah, that's fun. Okay, and then here's like a little beach entry into the pool with some more like water features. And then the pool is actually pretty big. There's a lot of like kids in it right now, so I'm not going to do too much filming, but it is a very nice pool area. You've got tables with chairs and umbrellas. You also have like the lounge chairs, which is really nice. And then there is a hot tub, but there's also people in there as well, so I'm not going to show you guys that. But if you're staying here at the Grand Legacy Hotel, I definitely recommend, especially if the weather is nice and warm, checking out and hanging out by the pool. And then as you can see, here's the pool hours from 8 a.m. to 10 p.m. And then here's a little glimpse of the hotel. This is such a nice hotel and it is so close to the parks. I'm talking like a 5-minute walk, which is super nice. It's been really great being able to go to the parks, but then come back to the room to, you know, take a little breather, change, and then go back at night. 10/10 recommend staying here. I will also leave a link to their website in the description below, so that way you guys can check out the hotel and book your next Disneyland vacation. Okay, so change of plans. Shelby's a little exhausted. So we are going to just hang out about the hotel. I was trying to see if their rooftop bar is. I did forget to like talk about that. But they do have a rooftop bar here that has amazing views of the parks. And they've got like food, obviously cocktails, and they also have like appetizers and stuff. And I thought that would have been really fun to do tonight. But they're closed Sundays and Mondays. So if you're coming here, just remember that the rooftop bar is closed Sundays and Mondays. But I think we're gonna check out the pizza and boba place and then maybe walk, I don't know, around like the hotel area and just see if we can find like some fun gift shops and see what other kinds of restaurants they have. So let's go. All right, so we're gonna check out the pizza and boba place that's right next door. It's called Pink Pig. Hi. That's the menu up there. And then they have a bunch of different like boba flavors too. Fruit tea. And then they also have milk tea. It looks really yummy. All right, we got our order number. Now we're gonna wait for our food. Oh, they look so good. Look how cute the cup is. I'm obsessed. All right, taste test. This is the taro milk tea with lychee jelly. Yep. That is so good. Do you like yours? Mm-hmm. Yum. I love a taro milk tea. Okay, this is Shelby's. It's like a grape slush. The popping boba. Mm-hmm. Wow, that's really good. This is very refreshing. All right, we got our pepperoni pizza. It actually looks pretty solid. It looks really good. It smells really good too. Let's do a little taste test. It's windy and cold right now. All right, I don't know how I'm gonna do this.
It's very greasy.
It's a little greasy, but that's okay. It's got pepperoni on it, so. It's windy and I'm trying to use my left hand so I can film with my right. Is it hot?
She's struggling over here.
This is so hot.
Okay.
Well, I'm gonna go for it. I'll take a small bite. It is hot though. It's burning my fingers.
There we go. Okay, the pepperoni is really good and the cheese is really flavorful. The crust is good too. I'm gonna give it like a 9 out of 10. This is delicious. Very good, very good.
All right, we just got done our pizza snack. We got our boba. We are gonna walk
just like around the corner and see if there's anything that we can find. So we're just gonna go on a little adventure.
All right, we found this souvenir shop.
They've got like some mugs, some little like coin purses, Disney photo frame. They've got lots of sunglasses. I'd be so excited if I found like Mickey ones. Some ears, princess crown. Some little games. Oops, sorry. They got a lot of stuff. Look at these. They're like little keychains. They've got a Lilo, Boba Fett. Those are cute. Oh wait, they got a little Sally. Here's some more up here. Oh look, Winnie the Pooh. So cute. You've got some more keychains over here. I like these little shops. You can always find some like fun, cute little things. Mini brands. These are like the little like mini brands toys. I stopped collecting those ones. More keychains. These ones are actually pretty cute. Just like the little heads, like that alien. They even have Belle, Ariel, Little Monsters Inc. Some Disney pins, which we all know they're fake. Oh wait, these aren't fake though. Look at these, they've got a Dumbo. They've got Ariel, Monsters Inc., Beauty and the Beast. I have that one. Oh, that's cute. Winnie the Pooh. I'm gonna hold that off for Shelby. They've got a Bambi one. 101 Dalmatians. I have that one. They got a Star Wars. I think that's Luke and Darth Vader. That's really cool. They've got a Mickey birthday, another Monsters Inc. They've got this Alice in Wonderland. I have that one as well. What is this? Another Winnie the Pooh. Yeah, that one's cute. They've got a Nightmare Before Christmas. Look, these are all on sale too. Look at this Winnie the Pooh. You can change out his face. Shelby loves Winnie the Pooh, so I'm gonna hold those to the side. And then I think another Little Mermaid. That's adorable. All right, we've got some more. It's like Disney 100 mystery packs. Those are fun. I think they're keychains. They're $3.99. That's awesome. Oh my gosh, look at these buttons. Cinderella. Oh my gosh. Look at this one. These are so stinking cute. Got a little alien, Buzz Lightyear. Okay, I'm obsessed with those. More Disney Store mini brands. Ooh, a little Harry Potter micro magical moment. I don't know if you can see that. Those are actually really cute. Oh my gosh, they have so much good stuff in here. Here's some more bag clips, mystery ones. They got a lot of cute stuff in here. I pulled out some pins for you up there. I'll show them to you. Look at these are so cute. You could make them into like little keychains. White rabbit. They're little Disney Tsum-Tsums. They've got Cheshire Cat. Little 101 Dalmatians. this one a little heart. We've got Simba. The store is probably the best little souvenir store we've found so far. I like these too. Oh my gosh, stop it right now. A Lotso alien. How cute is that? And they've got a sadness alien. They've got Remy, Woody. Adorable. Oh look, they've got a Winnie the Pooh shirt back there. I'm trying to put this back. They've got little Stitch remix ones too. Dalmatian, Simba. So cute. I would love if they had like some plush keychains or something. Oh my gosh, stop. Little Queen of Hearts plushie. That wouldn't be cute keychain too. I think these are all villains. There's Maleficent, Ursula. Who's back here? I think that's from Encanto maybe. So cute. Oh wait, they've got more stuff over here I missed. Excuse me, sorry. Oh, I thought it was princesses. It's not. Okay, that was just half the store. Let's go over here. So cute. Plushies, water bottles. What else? Oh my gosh, look at this little Winnie the Pooh. He's a cutesy. They got a flounder. Oh no. They have Sebastian. You guys. I want him. You never see him. I'm gonna hold on to him. We've got a Buzz Lightyear I see. Angel. They've got Tigger up there. Oh, look at this flounder. Hey, these look legit, like Disney parks. Yeah, Disney Prisoners, $15.99, that's it. This one's probably the same price. Why do I feel like I need Flounder and Sebastian? You never see them. Oh my gosh. Okay, I'm gonna put them right here together. I mean, look how cute they are. That alone just makes me want to get them, but I'm gonna think on it. Everything is so cute. I'm so glad we decided to walk down here. They've got some little bags. Look, they have a little Mickey plush bag. It doesn't look like it would hold too much, but for like decoration for your outfit, he's only $11.99. I'm gonna have to like open him and see like if he would even hold much. He'll probably just be like a cute little addition to your shoulder. I've got a like My Little Pony fan, like a water fan. Wow. That's cute. Hollywood best dad, mom, best parents. So cute. I am obsessed with everything. Little magnets. Love little Queen of Hearts. She's cute. Oh my gosh, look at this one. Sorry, Cheshire Cat. Look at his eyeballs. That's so funny. Ooh, here's some more plushy keychains. I grabbed these two from that one store we stopped at.
But they got a little Groot, Hulk, Dumbo. I saw those ones already. They got some pens and pencils. Oh, they've got some Pops up there. Ariel, Merida. They have Asha with Star, Cinderella. I stopped collecting those, but they are cute. Got some pens. I don't even know, you guys, if I can fit anything else in my suitcase. Oh yeah, lots of Pops. $13.99. Okay, so I'm just gonna say this store is awesome because they don't like highly mark up their merchandise. Usually a lot of stores mark up their merchandise super like high. This little Alice Wonderland car. But yeah, usually they mark it up high. And this place, I feel like everything is super discounted, which is nice. Did you get something?
Yeah, I got some stickers and the shot glass.
Stickers?
Yeah, that's the register.
Look at this blue. Did you see the pins?
I did. I saw them.
Look how cute. Okay, I want to show you what I got. All right, we're going to sign off here. I'm going to do some filming for TikTok.
Okay, well, that gift shop was super cool. I got 3 Tsum Tsums. I'm going to make them into, like, bag charms. But I'd like to mention that all of their stuff is, like, super cheap, super discounted. A lot of these stores, like, jack up the prices, and they definitely did not. We did find another one. It's called A-Mart. We are going to go in here, and then I think we're going to head back to the hotel.
All right, here we go. So about the same vibes. They've got some bags and t-shirts. I did see some more of those like TY little bag charms, but they didn't have any new characters. Here's some more plushies. Lots of t-shirts. Okay, so I did find these lip balms. They're super cute. Bubblegum flavor and cherry flavor. Not sure I would really use them, but I think they'll make really cute like accessories for some aesthetic Disney pictures. So I'm gonna grab these. Lots of pens. Pencils too. All right, they've got some mystery bag clips. These are super cute. I actually see some that I've never seen before. Like they have these little Christmas ones. How cute are those? Look at the little Belle. I would love if I got her. I actually might grab these. But they also have some Pride collection ones. Those are so cute. And then they have these ones too. Look at the little Mickey heart hands. Those are adorable. Okay, I ended up getting a basket just so they're easy to carry, but let's see if we can find anything else. So it looks like a lot of this stuff is just groceries, so I'm gonna work my way back towards the front. All right, so they have a ton of Funko Pops. They're only $14.99, but I do see a Beast, and I've never seen him before, and I think I'm gonna need him because I do have a Belle at home. Belle and Alice in Wonderland are the only ones that I'm still collecting, so I think I'm gonna grab him. Like, look how cute this is. And the Belle that I have, she's in her like winter outfit, and she's outside holding the birds too, I think, so. How cute. I'm gonna get that. All right, I'm also gonna get this one too because it's the scene where Lumiere asks how he feels and he goes stupid. So I'm gonna get this one because that's so cute.
All right, bag secured. Now we're heading back to the hotel. We are just going to shower, get in our PJs, watch some TV. Shelby's gonna show me the app Whatnot because I just bought some Funko Pops and I assume that they have some on there as well. And then yeah, we're just gonna hang out for the rest of the night. Tomorrow we are gonna be going to DCA for some Pixar Fest festivities. We decided to switch from Disneyland Park to DCA so we can enjoy Pixar Fest before we head out to go back home.
Okay, so here's a little haul of all of the stuff that I got from those corny little souvenir shops. I ended up getting the Beast Funko Pop. So cute. Again, only $16.99 or $15.99. I think that's such a great deal. Like I said, most of these gift shops really hike up the prices, but these ones didn't. And then I got this one. I got these little Mickey chapsticks. I got these Tsum Tsums. I'm going to turn these into little like bag charms. So I got Cheshire Cat. I got White Rabbit. I got 101 Dalmatians. And then I also picked up these mystery Christmas bag charms. Obviously, I know it is not Christmas, but I've actually never seen these. So I decided to grab a few. I'm really hoping for Belle, Ariel, Mickey, Minnie, or Pooh. They're really cute. I guess Tinkerbell would be cute too. And then here's the back. So there is a mystery. I'm assuming that's Mickey or Minnie. And then there's also Piglet. So I'm going to open these up with you guys in a little bit. But those are so stinking cute. I can't wait. I got to like YouTube how to make these into bag charms. But I know I've seen people do it. So it's not impossible.
Good morning. We are headed to DCA. It is our last morning here, so we are only going to be here till about like 1 o'clock, and then we have to head back to the hotel, get an Uber, and then head to the airport. I'm super sad, but we're going to go do all of the Pixar things. I think we're going to ride the racers again, and I don't know, check out Pixar Pier a little bit more because we didn't really do too much of that, but yeah, let's go.
Okay, we're back. I'm super sad. I am obsessed with Pixar Fest, low-key. I kind of want to like come back for a couple days, even if it's just me, because it is so much fun. But we're gonna head into DCA. All right, first up is Starbucks. It's really nice right now because it's not super busy. Park basically just opened. We're gonna head over to Monsters and ride that. Look how adorable this is. I've never seen this. This is so cute. Oh, I think Minnie's saying she wants a baby. That's so cute. Could you imagine they had little ones, like little Minnie and Mickey Mouse babies? All right, let's go on Monsters.
It made me dance
like a chicken. My thoughts were not my own. Then it grabbed me with
its jerry forked tongue.
There's a kid! A human kid!
Mission Academy. It's a complete Disney art course in one easy lesson. Right, Mickey?
You said it! And one of my pals will be there to teach you. Come on, it'll be lots of fun.
It
surely. Hey, which he actually precedes Disney as Disney characters go, because Mickey is the first Disney character. Awful is older than him. We also have my friend Vanessa up here. She's going to hang out with us during class in case you need something. Like if your pencil breaks, just raise your hand. But feel free to help yourselves to pencils next to you, too, if yours breaks. Vanessa's going to point out your exit doors in case you need to leave early from class. It's the same way you came in. As she's showing you which door you can open, the door on the far right, you give it a hard push. You can exit out at any time in case you got like a phone call or a lightning lane or you just want to bring us back a churro. It's right across the street. Pixar kind of a little revenge for Walt in that setting. But if you look at Oswald, you can see that his face is white, and his eyes and his fur are black. So this is to separate the two so we can see them clearly. The white space of his face is called a character mask, and that's what we need to add for our bowling ball. He looks like a bowling ball right now. We're going to add in that character mask, and just above the cheek, or just above the smile line, we're adding in his cheek. So I'm adding in another rainbow that connects to the side of my circle. From the open end of the cheek here, I'm going to bring up another parenthesis. So this is the left side of his eye. Now to separate the two eyes, Right up here at the top where that center guideline is, I'm going to add in another curvy letter V. And this edge, we won't see it on the right side because we'll see the edge of his face instead. So you should have these two curvy letter V shapes. His eyes can actually move anywhere within the boundaries of your guidelines. So your guidelines are where you want the eyes to not pass. Like, think of these as Gandalf. You shall not pass, you know, standing there with a staff. We're going to add in these pupils. And remember when I said circles and ovals were the easiest thing for them to animate? The eyes were usually these nice tall ovals. But you can draw different shapes if you want to. You want to draw hearts in his eyes like he sees his wife. He is a married rabbit. His wife is named Hortensia, and she's a cat. Don't think too hard about it. And the other eye here, I'm just going to sit it right behind the nose, so it kind of looks like he's looking straight out at all of you. And you want to make sure those eyes are really nice and dark, because this should be the focus of our sketch. This is where we connect with characters, because it's where we connect with each other, too, through eye contact. Now we have Oswald the bowling ball here. What do we need to make him a rabbit?
Ears.
His ears. And his ears, they can really do anything. Remember I said he could use his ears as helicopter blades. He can use them as scissors to cut something with if he needs to. But I'm going to have his ears sticking out here towards the left side. That's why I kind of moved my circle towards the right. So I'm actually going back to my center and pulling out a guideline over the cheek, over the smile. And then I'm going to have the other ear moved a little upwards here. So it's almost like you're sketching out this sideways letter V. Wherever you want the ears to end, because you can make these ears as long as you want. Like maybe they're tied together on a pole and he's stretching out this way to see you. But at the end of his ears, this is the widest part of them. So you want to cap off the ends with these two like letter Cs, horseshoe shapes. And I'm going to bring them together here and connect them back to his head. So it ends up looking like you have a baseball bat or a breadstick. Now, since we lost Oswald way back in the 1920s, probably like a mystery.
I'm done.
Okay, we just did the Radiator Springs Racers. Now we're walking around. We're gonna go to Pixar Pier. Some of like the Pixar food booths aren't opened, and we can't really get an exact time on when they opened. They were supposed to open at 10, I guess. Now they're saying 11, but who knows. But we're going to go get a corn dog from the Corn Dog Palace, because Shelby really wants to get one of those. And then we're gonna make our way through Pixar Pier, see if there's anything fun there. I did get some like pressed pennies, so I actually wanna get like a Disneyland pressed penny book so I can start like collecting them. But yeah, it's just a nice chill day. We only have a few more hours here, so we're gonna try and do as much as we can. And then we are going to head back to the hotel, get our bags, get an Uber, and then head to the airport. We got corn dogs from the Corn Dog Castle. Shelby requested it. Go ahead and take a bite. Good. Yeah, these are always really good. Okay, I just met May and Ming. They were super sweet. Now we're at the Four Town booth. We did get the Red Bow Bun again and the Nobody Like You cooler. These are so good. We're gonna try, I think, and hit like one more spot. But other than that, we're going to be heading out after this. Goodbye, Disneyland. We are now officially heading back to the hotel. We're gonna get our stuff, get our Uber, and head back to the airport to head back home. We're not gonna be back home until late tonight, like midnight. So Shelby's gonna sleep over and then I'm gonna bring her home tomorrow. But we had so much fun. Thank you again to the Grand Legacy Hotel for hosting us. We cannot wait to come back. I actually just booked a trip to come back in July with my friend Bianca. So I'm super excited for that. But until next time, bye.